Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 22nd video class of DIP, we will study homomorphic filtering and its implementation in MATLAB. So as usual, starting with the name itself, why? Because everything is there in the name. What is the meaning of homomorphic? So homomorphic is made up of two terms, homo plus morphic. Homo means similar or same, and morphic means shape or structure. So a filter which has got a similar shape as the high pass filter is known as homomorphic filter. And filter, you know, is a device that passes certain frequencies and rejects certain other frequencies. So for homomorphic filtering, we'll be passing the reflectance frequencies, or you can say the high frequencies, and of course we will implement this in MATLAB also. So let us start. We are studying different frequency domain filters from last few classes, in which we have studied the low pass filters, the high pass filters, as well as in the previous video class we have studied the high boost filter. In this video class we will study homomorphic filter. We are taking this also separately like the high boost filter, because it takes a different approach compared to the frequency domain filters which we have studied so far. Here the approach is to separate out the illumination and the reflectance coefficients, and increase the reflectance coefficient and decrease the illumination coefficient, and hence enhance the image. So this also is a type of image enhancement technique in the frequency domain. So this homomorphic filters use a different approach compared to the frequency domain filters. It normalizes the brightness across an image and increases the contrast. So it improves the appearance of an image by simultaneously intensity range compression or illumination compression and contrast enhancement or the reflectance enhancement. So where these homomorphic filters are used, these homomorphic filters can be used to enhance an image due to non-uniform illumination. Many a times we have seen in the image that some particular areas are visible properly and some other areas in the same image due to poor illumination are not visible properly. So in such places we can use a homomorphic filter. So illumination variations we can think as of a multiplicative noise and can be reduced by filtering in the log domain. So to evenly distribute the illumination, the high frequency components are increased and the low frequency components are decreased, because the high frequency components are assumed to present mostly the reflectance in the scene. Okay, that is the amount of light reflected off the object in the scene. So these are the high frequency components, right? So we have to increase this, whereas the low frequency components are assumed to represent mostly the illumination in the scene, and we have to decrease this low frequency components. Okay, so basically it is a type of high pass filter. Okay, that is used to suppress low frequencies and amplify high frequencies in the log intensity domain. So remember, the high frequency components are the reflectance components and the low frequency components are the illumination components, right? So we will increase this high frequency components and we will decrease this low frequency illumination components. Okay, and hence enhance our overall image by suppressing the low frequencies and amplifying the high frequencies. Before studying this homomorphic filter, let us remember the image formation model that we learned in our fourth video class of image sensing and acquisition. So if you have not seen that video class, please refer to that video class. So there we have seen that an image can be expressed as the product of illumination and reflectance components by f of xy is equal to I of xy into r of xy, where I of xy is the illumination component and r of xy is the reflectance component. So f is the gray level and x and y are the spatial coordinates. The images that we see are formed due to the fact that there is some amount of light falling on the object and some amount of light reflected from the object, where I of xy is the illumination component and R of xy is the reflectance component. As the images that we see fall in the electromagnetic spectrum, f of xy is in between 0 to infinite, and f of xy is characterized by two components, the amount of light incident on the scene and the amount of light reflected from the object, where I of xy is in between 0 to infinite. Why? Because the light can be up to infinite, right? Illumination can be up to infinite, but the reflectance will be in between 0 to 1, where 0 indicates total absorption and 1 indicates total reflection. Okay, so R is in between 0 to 1. So the homomorphic filtering uses this illumination reflectance model to filter images in the frequency domain. In homomorphic filtering, we separate the illumination and the reflectance components and work with them separately. Okay, but of this equation we cannot take directly the Fourier transform. Why? Because Fourier transform of f of xy is not equal to Fourier transform of I of xy into Fourier transform of r of xy. Therefore, to separate the I and r components, we use the log function. Okay, let us assume that z of xy is equal to log of f of xy. Then we can say that log of I of xy plus log of r of xy is equal to z of xy. So now taking the Fourier transform of z of xy, we get Fourier transform of ln I of xy plus Fourier transform of ln log natural r of xy. So now z of xy we will name as z of uv in the Fourier domain. I of xy is f I of uv and r of xy as f r of uv. So z of uv is equal to f I of uv plus fr of uv. Now say we process this z by means of a filter function h of uv. Okay, then s of uv is equal to h of uv into z of uv. Now it is in the Fourier domain, so we can multiply it, but z of uv is I of uv plus r of uv. Okay, so h of uv into I of uv plus of h of uv into r of uv. So in the spatial domain, we have to take the inverse Fourier transform of s of uv, and hence we have to take the inverse Fourier transform of both these terms like this. Let I dash of xy is Fourier inverse of h of uv into I of uv, and r dash of xy is the Fourier inverse of h of uv into r of uv. So hence s of xy is equal to I dash xy plus r dash xy. But as we had taken the log initially, that is z of xy was formed by taking the logarithmic of the original image, the inverse log or exponential operation yields the desired enhanced image denoted by g of xy. That is, g of xy is equal to e raised to s of xy, which is equal to e raised to I dash xy into e raised to r dash xy, which is say equal to I naught xy into r naught xy, where I naught xy is equal to e raised to I dash xy and r naught xy is equal to e raised to r dash xy. So the steps just discussed for homomorphic filtering can be shown by this block diagram. We have our input image, we are taking the log of the image, then taking the discrete Fourier transform of the image and applying the filter to our image, and taking the inverse Fourier transform, and after taking the inverse Fourier transform, we are taking the inverse log or exponential and get our enhanced image g of xy. So remember, the key approach in homomorphic filtering is to separate the illumination and the reflectance components. So between this, I of xy contributes to the low frequency since illumination is more or less uniform, and r of xy is the high frequency component since r of xy tends to vary abruptly at the junctions of dissimilar objects. So from this, we understand that our filter mask h of uv is basically a high pass filter mask that will be passing the high frequencies and suppressing the low frequency components, right? The illumination component of an image generally is characterized by slow spatial variations, while the reflectance component tends to vary abruptly, particularly at the junctions of dissimilar objects. So these characteristics leads to associating the low frequencies of the Fourier transform of the logarithmic of an image with illumination and high frequencies with reflectance. Although these associations are rough approximations, they can be used to advantage in image enhancement. So a very good deal of control can be gained over illumination and reflectance components with a homomorphic filter. This control requires specification of a filter function h of uv that affects the low and high frequency components of the Fourier transform in different ways. So this figure shows a cross section of such a filter. If the parameters gamma l and gamma h are chosen so that gamma l is less than 1 and gamma h is greater than 1, the filter function shown here tends to decrease the contribution made by low frequencies or illumination and amplify the contribution made by high frequencies or reflectance. So the net result is a simultaneous dynamic range compression and contrast enhancement, which can be shown like this, right? So the shape of this function can be approximated using the basic form of a high pass filter, as we have learned in the previous classes. For example, using a slightly modified form of the Gaussian high pass filter yields this particular function h of uv, which is equal to gamma h minus gamma l into 1 minus e raised to minus c d square uv upon d0 square plus of gamma l, where d of uv you know is the mass coefficient. The constant c controls the sharpness of the slope of this function as it transitions between gamma l and gamma h, and this filter is similar to the high emphasis filter that we have discussed in the previous video class. And see this equation. This equation is nothing but the equation of a Gaussian high pass filter, 1 minus e raised to minus d square upon d0 square. This is gamma h minus gamma l. So taking this portion is gamma h minus gamma l. This is our Gaussian high pass filter. This is gamma H minus gamma L, and the remaining portion is gamma L that we have to add up here. So in this way, this equation is formed. Getting it, right? So what will happen when we implement this equation? It will increase, of course, the high frequency components and compress the low frequency components, and the depending factors which will be enhancing high frequency component will be gamma H and compressing low frequency component will be gamma L. So when we implement the homomorphic filter, we will get an image that is evenly illuminated, and even the dark portions of the image that are not clearly visible in the input image will be visible in the output image. For example, this image. So you can see this is our original image, and this is the image that is processed by homomorphic filtering. So inside this shelter, we can see the details which are not visible in the original image. Why? Because we here compress the low frequency components and enhance the reflectance component, due to which the other objects in the image are also now visible properly. Let us implement this in MATLAB. So this program shows homomorphic filtering, and this program is similar to the program that we have developed in the previous three video classes. So if you are not clear in the steps of frequency domain filtering, you are requested to please visit the previous three video classes first for better understanding. As usual, I am reading an image and converting that image to grayscale image if it is a color image, and subplotting in one of the portions out of six portions. Then I am storing the input image in a second variable B. The constants which I am choosing for this filter are D0, that is cutoff frequency is equal to 50, as we have already chosen in the previous classes also. The gamma low that we have just seen in the theory is GL over here, which I am choosing 0.9. Gamma high I am choosing as 1.9. So you know that gamma low should be less than 1 and gamma high should be greater than 1. Then again, I am finding the size of the image and storing the values in M and N. To my image, I am adding 1. Why I am adding this? Because we will remove the 0 values, which would result in undefined log values, because we will be taking the log of this input image. So it should not be 0, right? Therefore, we are adding 1. Then taking the log of the input image as per the procedure of homomorphic filtering and subplotting in one another portion. Then we will be taking a 2-dimensional FFT and subplotting it in the third portion, and we will be shifting our image using FFT shift to center the transform. Then again I am running the for loop for U and V, that is different coordinates of our image. Then I am finding my homomorphic filter. H of UV is equal to gamma high minus gamma low into 1 minus e raised to minus c d square upon d0 square plus of gamma L. So gamma high and gamma low values we have already chosen. C value we are choosing minus 1, that controls the sharpness. And this is our D, which you already know for finding out the Euclidean distance, that is under root of U minus M by 2 whole square plus of V minus N by 2 whole square. D0 we have already chosen, and GL also you know. So this is our filter mask that is developed. This filter mask I'll be displaying in the fourth portion in the mesh plot, or you can say the perspective plot of homomorphic filter. I am multiplying my image to this homomorphic filter and displaying the real portion of it. Now, as we have taken log initially for obtaining our final enhanced image, we have to take the anti-log or inverse log, and that I am doing here by taking the exponential, and then I am plotting my final filtered image in the last portion. So let us run the program and see the output. So you can see this is our input image, which is a poor illuminated image, which doesn't have details towards this end and this end. And to get these details properly, we are using homomorphic filtering. So this is the natural log image that we obtain, the Fourier transform of the image, and this is the homomorphic filter mesh plot that you can see over here. So it is similar to the high pass filter, because homomorphic filter is basically a type of Gaussian high pass filter. So the value are 0.9 to 1.9, as you can see here in the figure, and then taking the inverse Fourier transform, such result, and final result will be like this. So now you can see that after applying homomorphic filter, the illumination has become more even, and the areas in the image which are not visible properly over here and here are very nicely visible towards this end. Let us zoom this particular portion and see the output. In the same, I'll be zooming over here. So now you can see the design on the door of the car, which is not visible properly over here, is very nicely seen over here. Similarly, you can see this portion, which is not visible properly, it is very nicely visible over here. This handle of the compartment box, which is not at all visible over here, is now visible over here. So you can see this. Let us change the values of gamma and see the output. Let us change the values of gamma high from 1.9 to 2.9. So now you can see that the image has become more brighter. So you can say homomorphic filtering is similar to the log and gamma functions that we were applying in the spatial domain. But here we are using the frequency domain, and you know all the advantages of frequency domain filtering that it is computationally more efficient as well as cheaper and faster to perform. Let us bring back gamma low and gamma high to original values, and now let us run the same program with different inbuilt images of MATLAB. So that is all for this video class. I hope you would have gained a very good knowledge from this video class. Thank you very much.